You have a normal life, quiet existence, nothing stands out. You work in an office, enjoy your weekends, enjoy a beer on a sunny day, nothing remarkable. Then one day you wake up and stumble upon an incredible truth, that you are living in a simulation. You are not real. You are information contained within bits of ones and zeros. What will you do? Will you make choices that are different? Or will you continue your mundane existence? What does an ancient philosopher have to do with simulation hypothesis, a contemporary scientific thought experiment? Meet René Descartes, a 16th century French philosopher whose ideas continue to shape the way we think about reality and existence. Descartes, often referred to as the father of modern philosophy, pondered deeply on the nature of reality and the human experience. One of his most fascinating ideas, one that feels eerily relevant in our age of technology, is his notion that we might be living in a simulation. Descartes, in his quest for truth, famously declared, "I think, therefore I am." He believed that the act of thinking was proof of one's existence, but what if our thoughts themselves were part of a larger construct, a simulated reality designed by some higher intelligence or advanced civilization? Imagine waking up one morning and realizing that the reality you've always known might not be as concrete as you once believed. Descartes contemplated the possibility that our senses could deceive us, that what we perceive as reality might merely be an illusion created by a powerful entity. In his work, Meditations on First Philosophy, Descartes explores the concept of radical doubt, questioning everything he once took for granted. He imagines an evil demon capable of deceiving us into believing falsehoods about the world around us. This scenario forces us to confront the limitations of our knowledge and the uncertainty of our perceptions. Fast forward to the present day, where advancements in technology have brought us closer to the realm of virtual reality and artificial intelligence. We create simulated worlds in video games, explore virtual environments, and interact with AI entities that mimic human behavior. Could it be possible that our own reality is just a more sophisticated version of these simulations? The idea that we might be living in a simulation isn't just a thought experiment anymore. Some scientists and philosophers seriously entertain the possibility, citing arguments from quantum physics, computational theory, and even the observation that our universe seems to operate according to mathematical laws. Many technologists and scientists believe that the odds of us living in base reality, the original, unsimulated reality, are 1 in billions. They further argue that if civilizations continue to advance technologically, they will inevitably create simulations indistinguishable from reality. Descartes' musings on the nature of reality find a striking parallel in the theory proposed by philosopher Nick Bostrom, known as the simulation hypothesis. Bostrom suggests that if it's possible for advanced civilizations to create simulations indistinguishable from reality, then the odds are high that we ourselves are living in such a simulation. This hypothesis builds upon Descartes' skepticism about the reliability of our perceptions and the limitations of our knowledge. Just as Descartes imagined an evil demon capable of deceiving us, Bostrom proposes the idea of a technologically advanced civilization creating simulated worlds inhabited by conscious beings. While Descartes' evil demon is a thought experiment meant to challenge our assumptions about reality, Bostrom's simulation hypothesis raises profound questions about the nature of existence and our place within a potentially simulated universe. But these are not merely wild hypotheses. Our reality is somewhat strange. Dr. Sylvester James Gates Jr. is a theoretical physicist who studies supersymmetry. This theory is an extension of the standard model of particle physics, suggesting every fundamental particle we know, like electrons and quarks, has a corresponding partner particle that we have yet to discover. These partner particles are supposed to help fill in some gaps in our current understanding of the universe, like why particles have mass and what dark matter is made of. While working with the complex mathematics of supersymmetry, Dr. Gates found something eerily strange. In the equations that describe how these fundamental particles behave, he identified patterns that look very similar to error-correcting codes used in computer science. These codes, specifically the doubly even self-dual linear binary error-correcting block codes, are indeed known for their use in computer science to correct errors in data transmission. The presence of these error-correcting codes within the fundamental laws of physics is bewildering because it suggests that the underlying structure of the universe might be similar to the framework of a computer system. In other words, the way particles interact and the way the universe operates could be governed by a set of rules similar to how data is processed and protected in computers. Dr. Gates' discovery raises intriguing questions about the fabric of reality. It suggests that the universe might be built on principles of information processing and error correction, which is a concept that blurs the lines between physical reality and the digital world. So what does it all mean for us, knowing that our reality might be just a sophisticated simulation? Would anything change in our external world? In our everyday lives? Perhaps not. We would still wake up, go to work, eat dinner, and go to sleep. The mundanity of our existence may remain unchanged. But internally, within the confines of our minds, everything could shift. The realization that our reality is not as concrete as we once believed would challenge the very foundations of our understanding. It would force us to confront questions about the nature of existence, the meaning of life and death. What does it mean for our beliefs about death, rebirth, and concepts like religion? Could these ideas and beliefs be altered by the knowledge that we are living in a simulation? Ultimately, the truth is that we may never know for certain. Whether we exist in a simulation or in base reality, the experiences we have, the relationships we build, and the choices we make still shape our lives in profound ways. This is when it is useful to consider the existential philosophy of Jean-Paul Sartre and Albert Camus. They offer a poignant lens through which to explore our simulated predicament. They speak of the absurd, the realization that the universe is indifferent to our quests for meaning. And yet it is precisely in this indifference that our freedom and our responsibility to create meaning emerge. If our reality is indeed a simulation, does this not amplify the absurdity of existence and simultaneously our freedom within it? In a simulated world, the constructs of death, faith, and the divine take on new dimensions. The existentialist assertion that we are condemned to be free, to make choices in a world devoid of inherent meaning, becomes all the more real. Our simulated existence does not negate the search for meaning. Rather, it only highlights the beauty and tragedy of our attempts to find or create it. Perhaps the most significant realization is that regardless of the nature of our reality, the power to create meaning, purpose, and fulfillment lies within us. So next time when you think nothing has meaning, or when you quietly sigh, "What's the point?" think of this. Yes, it might all be true. Probably none of this has any meaning. There might not be a point to this existence. Everything might just be futile. But this very nihilistic thought might just be an incredible superpower. You might absolutely be free within the shackles of this simulated existence. Yes, absolutely free to choose that career path you've been wondering about, or to approach that girl you have a crush on, or to start a business you've always dreamed of, to confront your fears, whatever they may be. Yes, things are still meaningless on the larger scheme of things, but you are free to create your own meaning, observe and orchestrate your own life. What other choice do you have other than to live free to the best of your ability? Maybe there might be a true choice when you finally wake up once and for all. Until then, be free. That's it for today's video. If you enjoyed this, like, share with your like-minded friends, subscribe, and most importantly, press the bell icon to get notified when I post a new video. Stay strong, keep going, and I will see you soon.